Hello everyone, welcome to Katharine's Q&A, episode 15. This is a series where you can ask an author pretty much anything. And today we're kind of talking about a couple different social media platforms that can benefit a aspiring writer or author, if you're already an author. And we're gonna start off today with Instagram. So Instagram is a platform easily accessible on the phone, if you have a smartphone or a computer, but it is a platform that is meant to share images or live videos or video recordings. It's very fun, laid back, communal, and it's a nice platform where you can let your followers know a little bit more about yourself, and you don't have to be very as cut and dry as you need to be on maybe some of the other platforms. And it's a great place not only to network with readership, but other authors and a group of people called bookstagrammers. And if you don't know what a bookstagrammer is, these are the people who do beauty shots, essentially, for book covers. You'll see images that are, you know, visually attractive and little vignettes. They usually have huge followings. And it's nice to know a few of those because you never know, down the line, they may want to do a photo shoot of one of your books. So, great way to find them. On Instagram, you do need to post, like I said, a picture or a video. Then you can kind of talk about your content below. Always remember to add some hashtags. So, hashtag yourself, your author's name. If you use a different name, just remember to always use your author's name. If you're posting about maybe one of your books or your writing, again, hashtag your book title. If it's part of a series, the series title as well. Again, these are the ways that some people can link to each other and follow you and find you. You can also talk about, you know, kind of pretty much anything. What you've been doing, if you had a vacation recently, maybe throw a few appropriate vacation videos on there. Make it fun, make it interesting, but it's a nice platform to get on. Now, one thing I do want to mention about that, it is hard to add active links. So I think on your profile page, you can add one. I usually just set it to my author website, but some people will rotate it. And so depending on what they've recently released, they'll have the buy link up there. So it'll send people over to Amazon or what have you that way. But when you're doing your daily posts, and yes, you should probably post on Instagram at least once a day. When you do your daily post, it won't necessarily let you add a live link. So you can type out the whole link and hope someone's going to copy and paste it and take that time. But again, any more energy than is necessary, people usually shy away from. So do keep that in mind when you do use Instagram. But outside of that, it is a great way to network and be fun and let people and your viewers get to know the real you. Another thing to note about Instagram, you can actually link it to your author's page on Facebook, so you can send posts back and forth between the two. And also when you're on Instagram, you can also send stuff over to your Twitter account if you have one as well. So that's nice if you're a person that's crunched on time, getting new, you know, getting into all these platforms and just starting off, you can post one place and it sends to three different platforms. That is very nice. Do keep in mind, if that is what you start off with, you want to encourage each follower to follow you on all your platforms. So if you're always sharing the same content on every platform, they're less likely to follow you more than one. So just consider that, because you may want to change things out in the future when you have a little more time or build your daily structure differently. But yeah, think about that. Another cool thing about Instagram right now, there's currently a trend. It's called follow trains or follow circles. And these are like little micro networking events for the bookish community. And so people in the bookish community are the authors, bookstagrammers, maybe even just everyday people who love to read and just talk about what they're reading. So it's a nice community to get involved with and network and get to know. If you are interested in joining one of those events, it's pretty simple. You are usually required, you're required to follow the host or hosts. And so make sure you do that. You are usually required to like and share the post. Again, networking, trying to spread the word. And then make sure you read the content every time, because half the time the host will pose a question to see if you're actually paying attention, and they require you to answer it. If you don't answer it, they are allowed to remove you from the group because it's kind of rude when you're not reading all the facts, even though you may have seen this kind of form a thousand times. Once you answer the question, you are required to tag X amount of other people in the bookish community. So once you have a couple people who are following you and you kind of already know, these are kind of nice ways to get involved because you can tag each other and start building a following pretty rapidly. The last thing to keep in mind is you are required to follow everybody who's participating, and anybody who follows you during that time frame, you're supposed to follow back. One thing, or another thing to note, is that there will be eventually a cap on how many people you can follow on the platform, but that's later on. That's when you have thousands, more than several thousand followers. So not something to worry about when you're starting off, but is something to keep in mind in the back, you know, be aware of in the end. But follow trains are great, really easy to do, don't cost anything, great way to network. I actually have been enjoying them. It's been helping me boost my following in the bookish community. The other one, well, actually, looking at the time, that may be it. Well, that is it for today. If you have any questions for me, then I guess you can post them on the comments below or contact me on my social media. And until next time, skull.